Terry, the singer.
I'm Dave, and I play the drums.
I'm Dave, and I play the keyboards.
I'm Jack, and I play the bass.
I'm Nick, and I play the guitar.
Cam, and I play the guitar.
We are drive-wise. I struggle to the place on 10. Love letters on a foam wall fan.
Covered up with a gypsy screen for you. We're from the northeast of Scotland. We all come really from Aberdeenshire, which is just the area just around the city. We're all really country lads. When we first had the harebrained scheme to come and play in America, it was only going to ever be New York. Being as geographically naive as we are, we said, oh, well, why not, if we're going to beat America, why not just go to LA? You know, it can't be that far. 3,000 miles later, and some financially crippling flights, we ended up in Los Angeles playing a show at the Viper Room. That was the night that kind of changed everything for us.
You know, the A&R people had their cell phones up, playing, you know, listening to our music as we play, and it was Hollywood right there.
It really was. It was really Hollywood. It was for a bunch of guys from Aberdeen, Scotland, a part of the world where the concept of getting to do this for a living is just so far removed from reality. Can't be the biggest band in the world without doing some TV first.
So. We're playing Craig Ferguson.
Scottish.
He was a Scottish guy, so the irony of it all, really. You know, yeah. We come 5,000 miles or so, and you know, we play to a Scottish guy on TV. You know,
see,
in America,
it's jobs for the boys. It's the highest level of nudge, nudge, wink, wink. You know, he cut through all the red tape. Scottish band, in front of the line, lads. Come on.
It's a Celtic mafia that
the
we're
Celtic
building.
Mafia. You know? Yeah.
It doesn't exist.
Tremendous culture shock when we first got here. We're kind of lucky in a way because we're actually very well adjusted now. We're just as happy being in America as we are back in the UK. So touring's really not a bother for us, and we love the country. But the challenges it brought was a good source of inspiration for writing, and I mean, it still is. You know, there's a lot to think about.
I mean, being a listener as well as a participant in Driveline, the lyrics that Terry has are honest lyrics, and I think that's really important. You know, I mean, they are obvious, but they're honest, and I think that's missing today anyway. You know, mixed metaphors and whatnot, and Terry just says it really simply.
I think it's a reflection of the kind of the struggle of position we were all in. We had, you know, dead end jobs with no real prospects of getting anywhere or doing anything like be musicians for a living, and then you couple into that your own search for wanting, feeling like you could do something better, and then you come here, and it's not the bowl of cherries. I mean, you've got to fight the culture shock, and you've got to get used to the idea, and it's all on there on the record. I mean, the whole having to leave our homes and our families behind, having to struggle like your love lives, all taking a diving header as you cross continents. We wouldn't have that record sitting there if we didn't, you know, labour. You know, it's our labour of love, really. I mean, the whole thing. And I think the lyrics reflect that.
That's where bands live. They live on a stage in front of an audience. I mean, the dynamic on a record is 1,000 miles away from what actually happens on stage. You've got the chemistry on stage. You've got, you know, a good and a bad sound mix. You're in the moment with a live performance.
I don't think you want your record to sound entirely like you do play live, because the studio is where you can do things you can't do on a stage, and a stage is where you can do things you can't do in the studio. There's nothing more miserable than getting a CD, listening to it, and then going to watch the band, and you're like, I may as well have just turned on the CD. It's like, what was the point? When you get to a certain point on your tour, maybe midway through, you know, you're so finely tuned and you're reading each other's thoughts practically, and that's the place that any band wants to be. So going out on tour, and it's worth it for that alone, just because you push yourself as a band, and before you know it, you're on that plateau where you could wake you up at 3 a.m. and just go play. And you could, without thinking about it, you could just kick into it. Not that I'd want somebody to wake me up at 3 a.m. and say play.